Well, hello there again. Here we are on Monday, June 29th, 2020 at 8:58 p.m. up here in northeastern Ohio. And over here in the southern sky, we have a 69% lit moon up there. And once again, we are on the Nikon P1000 as we test it out further. And it seems to be coming in pretty good at this time of day, at least at this zoom range. I'm gonna get a clip before we go any further. I'll be right back. Okay, there we go. We'll try to do a stacking if it comes out. But let's zoom in further. Wow, look at those tons of craters down there. My goodness. There's just so many of them. And there we go. We're in all the way. It's coming in okay, but I see a lot of digital lines in there. And so we'll stroll around, see what's shaking up there. Our little mountain range. And what I refer to as a boneyard over there. And over to what I call the light beam area and the mesa and our question mark. Yeah. And I always do that the wrong way. So yeah, it's coming out all right. But let's take her down to the full image there. I haven't seen anything unusual passing by. Now, I did follow a suggestion from somebody in my comment section who mentioned I should probably do a firmware upgrade again on the camera, which I did do, but it doesn't seem to have. What in the world is causing those shakes? Everything is still right here. Nothing's touching a tripod, but every so often. It's like something under the ground is heave-hoeing. Let's hope not. Anyway, yeah, somebody in my comment section, and I'm sorry, I forget who you were, they mentioned,
there it is again.
Oh, I'm sorry, there is some spam. Doggone it. Produce testosterone naturally. Improve energy, sex drive, strength. Oh my gosh. Spammers should be banned from the universe. Anyway, I did follow their suggestion of redoing the firmware on the camera, but I don't think it really had much impact on it. And I'd already done the factory reset for the settings and changed the batteries, and I use Nikon batteries and all that. So I just think it's a bit knackered. This poor thing, I've had it out here for a good 2 years now in all weather conditions, sub-zero weather, getting the planets, sun, moon, stars. and a few odd things passing by. So I think it's just a bit tired. You see those shakes every so often? I have no clue what is causing it. The wind is still, nothing is touching this tripod. And I don't feel the ground rumbling beneath me, so I don't know. Something's up. But now I'm going to make it go all jumpy. There we are. And it's a shame the colors this camera produces. And the color blue is one issue I have with this camera. I don't use automatic white balance. I have it set to I have all my cameras set to daylight because that's what some astrophotographers had suggested. So I just leave it on daylight for all the time, night and day. So it's not that. Now you're gonna see on this monitor, unless I am able to adjust the color in Final Cut Pro, but it looks so blue and everything. But it's a pretty much a total whiteout up there. Anyway, there's nothing else up here. No clouds, just a white sky, and even though you're looking at blue. Wow. Battery exhausted again. My goodness, I can't believe that. Didn't I charge that last night? You know, that may be user error, or I don't know. I could have swore I charged it last night. Oh my. So on that exhausting note, I'm going to wish you all a wonderful night and a great new week ahead. Y'all take care. It's now 9:12 p.m. up here in northeastern Ohio. Bye now. My own.